And this is my channel. Welcome to another video. Today we're gonna be doing a reaction that may upset some of you guys. So massive trigger warning, okay? If you are going through something similar, you guys can tell by the title and the thumbnail, please just click off. I'm gonna try to not say the word in the video because monetization. But we're going to be talking about a man trying to get a woman to get rid of her baby, right? Who's in the right? Who's in the wrong? This is a topic that I see brought up all the time, and I feel like I have a really, really hot take on it because it's like I really can't. I'm very, very tired of children being born into broken homes and just broken situations, and most importantly born to people that just genuinely don't fucking like each other, okay? Like there's no reason why anyone should be in these types of situations. So with that being said, grab your tea, grab your snacks, grab everything you need while I tell you that this video is sponsored by no one but me. Gotcha, okay? If you guys are not aware, I do have a business called Media Hustle where I do consultations for those of you guys who want to be YouTubers. Whether you want to start your YouTube channel, your TikTok, your Instagram, whatever your online platform is, I can help you with that. I do mentorships, I do consultations. I can also do a full-blown strategic plan for you. Make sure you guys head down to the link in the description and or the pinned comment down below and you get started today. So, let's see what we're dealing with. This video is super duper short, but it speaks volumes. So, I'm gonna have a lot to say. Alright, so it's very hard to hear the audio because clearly someone is recording this from their window. So essentially, first of all, let's just right off the bat, you can tell that this is a really bad situation. This girl is being grabbed up by this man that is supposed to be someone that she's in a relationship with, a situationship with. Some way, somehow, they were romantically involved because clearly we're talking about getting rid of a child, right? There's no way you should be romantically involved with anyone that is handling you this way. So if you're in that situation, just get the fuck out now. I don't want to hear it. I don't know why you're snailing, just get out. Why would you even want to have a child with someone who treats you this way? If you guys could hear the audio, essentially he's saying, get off me, don't grab me, I don't want to have this baby with you. That's scary because we all know how these stories end out. Next thing you know, the man ends up offing her or ends up taking the child and doing whatever with the child. This is scary. This is a conversation that needs to be had, you know, because there's so many children that were born out of situations like this, but I've never seen it play out publicly like this. Okay. Like I said, the clip was extremely short, but it speaks volumes. Okay, so essentially, as you guys can tell, if you can't hear it, basically the whole gist of the conversation is, get off me, I don't want you, I don't want this kid by you, and she's basically running away because he's trying to get her to get rid of the baby. I don't think this is right. I think this is actually fucked up. You laid down with the woman, you probably raw dogged the woman, and now she's pregnant. This is what happens when you raw dog. There's a possibility of getting pregnant, there's a possibility of STDs, there's a possibility of attachment, there's a possibility of a lot of other crazy things. You accept the risks when you lay down with someone. Not only unprotected, but even protected, because protected, you could still get pregnant. I don't know why a lot of people forget that. You could still get pregnant on birth control. You could still get pregnant with a condom on. You could still get pregnant on a lot of different circumstances, even if you're circumcised or your tubes are tied. Is it extremely rare? Yes, but it can happen. What I need y'all to understand is y'all need to be very, very careful who you lay down with, because these situations are so fucking common. It's insane. Another thing, I'm not trying to say that this man is right by any means. This is wrong and it's disgusting. And to be honest, I really hope she don't deal with this man ever again. I don't know what she chose to do. If she wants to keep the child, it is her prerogative. However, this man clearly said, I do not want this child by you. I do not want you. What do you think is going to happen with you and this child? What do you think? How do you think he's going to treat you and this child? That's what I would like to know. Comment down below. What do you think is going to happen? Because a lot of people seem to live in delusion. Oh, well, he had this baby with me. He has to take care of it. Legally? Yes. Morally? Yes. Realistically? No. He said he does not want this child by you. You can do whatever the fuck you want. My body, my choice. Correct? You choose to keep it. At this point, with what this man said, you understand you're going to be a single mother. You have accepted that at this point. If you go ahead with this, you're gonna be a single mother. And I'm speaking facts. This is not even an opinion. This is what the man essentially is saying. I don't want you. I don't want you. And I don't want this baby by you. This is what this man is saying. If you go ahead and keep this baby, you're going to be a single mother. This mother's not gonna give a fuck. And I've seen this happen to so many people, and the next thing you know, they turn around like, oh, I don't understand why he's not taking care of the baby. I don't know why he's not taking care of his responsibility. I don't know why he treat me like this. He's treating me like this because he said he never wanted a baby. Granted, men, y'all need to stop sleeping with any and everything, and y'all need to stop sleeping with people that you can't see yourself having a child with. I literally started following that philosophy for a while. Like, before, when I was single, I was like, you know what? If I'm gonna sleep with somebody, I'm gonna make sure they got their life together, and if I end up having a baby with them, I would be okay. Because it's getting to a point where, like, you never know. Anything can happen. Anything can happen. And you guys need to start thinking like that too. You can't just be having a good time all the fucking time. Life is not a fucking circus. It's not a merry-go-round. But a lot of y'all like to treat your life like it's a fucking circus. Take your life seriously. Stop opening your legs for everybody. Stop sticking your dick in everything. It's problematic. And in the circumstance that maybe he was an amazing guy and all of a sudden he flipped on her as soon as she was pregnant. Again, why would you want to keep a baby by someone that's like that? I personally would not want to. You could just take that baby and go your separate ways. And maybe that's what was going on. She was like, you know what? I don't care. I'm gonna keep the baby. Bye. Because I've seen that happen too, where it's like, you know what? He said he don't want to be involved. I'm just gonna take care of my baby. They go their separate ways. Never hear from each other ever again. That's what was going on. I commend her for that, because that takes a lot of strength, and it takes a lot of courage, and most importantly, it takes a lot of money, because at this point, you're going to be by yourself. This man is not going to contribute shit, not emotionally, financially, or anything. So if that's that type of situation, that's completely different. Like, clearly, like, there's a lot of men that do blindside us, right? But I feel like a lot of us, we kind of put on the rose-colored glasses when it comes to a lot of men that we deal with. We see the signs, people tell us about the man, or we know the type of man that the person is, and we just ignore it. You know, we're like, oh, you know, what's the worst that can happen? Oh, well, you know, he wouldn't do it to me. Oh, you know what? I really, really love him. He's a great guy. I know that these are red flags, but at the end of the day, it's gonna work out. But then when it doesn't work out, all of a sudden we're looking left and right and we're confused when our friends, our families, and everyone else told us what was going on. And I know for a lot of people that go through these types of situations, you guys are probably just thinking, oh, your mother or your father hates everyone you date. Your friends are haters. You know, people are just being judgmental. But to be quite honest with you, they're not necessarily being judgmental. They can see what you can't. When you're in love with someone, you're not going to be able to see their faults. You're not going to be able to see what their issues are. Everyone else around you can. And if people around you are telling you, hey, your significant other is a liar, a cheater, he's suspicious, he look like he don't treat you right, you don't look happy, you should probably look into it. You know, because a lot of these situations are not out of the blue. Is it 100% possible? Yes. But a lot of these times, like when I've seen people, like I've had people in my life where this happened to them, and they tell me the story, and I'm picking up the red flag from the first fucking sentence. Well, you know, I met this man on Facebook, and you know, I saw his girlfriend on his page, but he said that they weren't together. Oh, well, you know, I met him on Tinder, but he catfished me because he didn't look like his pictures. Well, you know, he said he never wanted to have a baby with me, but he said he would still pop in here and there, so I decided to still have the baby anyway. But then on social media and to everyone else, oh, he a deadbeat, he don't give a fuck about me, he don't give a fuck about his child, and why he acting like that, he just switched up. No, that's not what you told me. That's not what you told me, Rebecca. That's not what you told me, Alexis. That's not what you told me. You told me the real story. And the real story is you saw the red flags and you thought it was carnival. We need to stop this, okay? Men, women, we need to stop this. We need to start seeing people for who they are and not who they can be. Stop falling in love with potential. Stop falling in love with the good things that they do for us once a week. Fall in love with the bad things that they do for the other fucking 6 days, because that's who the fuck they truly are. Stop falling in love with potential, because potentially you're gonna be in a bad situation. This is just absolutely outrageous. And under no circumstance should any man or woman be forcing you to get rid of your child. That's absolutely ludicrous. That is her choice. If she wants to get rid of it, she should get rid of it. If she doesn't, then she doesn't. But understand, whatever you do, there's consequences to it. And the consequences to your actions are not because of the consequences of that person's actions that you think forced you to do it. Now, when it comes to these men, I just could never understand why they think that it's okay to not take responsibility for these kids. kids. Just because you said, I don't want a baby with you, doesn't mean the baby's not going to be born. It doesn't mean that you're still not going to be on the hook for this child. Legally, if this child does turn out to be yours, you know, paternity tests and all of that extra shit, you're going to be paying child support. You did lay down and have this child. And at the end of the day, whether you want to or not, you should be taking care of this child. And you're probably going to have to if this woman chooses to pursue it in the court system, okay? I get that a lot of men be like, listen, I said it from the jump, I want a baby with her, da da da. But it's like, at this point, you guys should look into signing your parental rights away at this point. Because a lot of y'all, next thing you know, 20 years later, y'all want to be in the kid's life when they're the next fucking Jay-Z. When they're the next fucking great football player and all of this goofy shit. It's like, come on now, you ain't do shit for this child. Now you want to claim that you was there because they great. Nigga, you had no hand in that child being great. You should have been there from the get, you know, to take care of your business. They have this mentality, and then some of them even go to grave lengths to take out this baby mother, take out the child even. And it's scary because it's like, take up for your responsibility, bro. Take up for your responsibility, you know? And if you're not going to, only have sex with women that you would have no problem being stuck to. It might be a very hard ask, but I don't think it's that difficult. Why y'all so damn bored and y'all like that? Y'all have time to be fucking and sucking everything anyways. Be booked and busy. Get a life. Do something. Find a hobby. Do something that you don't have time to stick your pity wecker in everything moving. Like, a lot of y'all, that's the problem. Y'all have too much time on your hands. Too much. And that's why you're getting in these fucking situations. You don't value yourself. You don't value others. You don't respect shit. But you're dropping kids all over this world. And then some way, somehow, it's the woman's fault. It's not her fault. At this point, she shouldn't have this child because you said you're not gonna take care of it. At this point, she assumes responsibility. But it's not just her fault. It's your fault too. Both of you guys are culpable in this situation. With that being said, comment down below. What did you guys think about this video? Has this ever happened to you? I'd love to hear your stories down below. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Schedule a consultation with Media Hustle. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye! No.